Good morning children, Saira. Today's lesson is the concluding part of chapter 2, whole numbers. This is part 6 of the chapter. So what are we going to learn today? Yes, we are going to learn a few more number patterns which will help us in multiplying numbers by shortcut methods. Then we will complete exercise 2.3. We will also discuss about the mathematics project which you are going to complete during your summer break. So let's start by number patterns. Children, in the previous session you learned how to add or subtract numbers by 999, such numbers by using shortcut methods, by using patterns, all right. And also I gave you few multiplication sums to use the patterns and solve them. Did you do that? Okay, let's discuss how we do them, and if you have done them, check whether your answers are right or not. Now, let's see the first one. It is 156 multiplied by 9. So, in place of 9, we take 10 minus 1, all right, and multiply 156 with that, by using distributive property. Now the next one is 156 multiplied by 99. All right, same method, 99 will be taken as 100 minus 1, and multiplying 156 by 999, again 999 we will take it as 1000 minus 1000 minus 1. All right, such shortcut methods help us to solve the sums easily, and even we can do them verbally. So let's see how we solve them. Now the first one, 156 multiplied by 9. So we have taken 9 as 10 minus 1, isn't it? We have taken 9 as 10 minus 1. Now using distributive property, we will write it as 156 multiplied by 10 minus 156 multiplied by 1. So what is the result? We get 1560 minus 156, and the result we get is 1404, isn't it? Similarly, when we multiply the number 156 by 99, so in place of 99, we consider the number 100 minus 1, 99 as 100 minus 1. Now using distributive property, we will multiply 156 by 100 and 156 by 1, and then do the subtraction. All right. So what is the answer that we get? We get 15,444 as the answer. Now the next one, 156 multiplied by 999. Again in place of 999, we take it as 1000 minus 1. Using distributive property, it becomes 156 multiplied by 1000 minus 156 multiplied by 1. So what do we get? We get 156,000 minus 156. And what is the answer that we get? It is 155,844. All right. This is the way we can multiply the numbers as big as 99,999 to any number. All right. Now let's move on to the next one. Pattern of multiplying a number by 5 or 25 or 125. That means the numbers that end with 5 or which have 5 in one's place. So how do we solve them? Now let's see that. Children, if we want to multiply 96 by 5, so what we do, instead of 5, we can take the number as 10 upon we can take the number as 10 upon 2, isn't it? And dividing 96 by 2 is very simple. We get 48. So what is the answer that we get? It is 480. Now see the second one, 96 multiplied by 25. So in place of 25, we take it as 100 upon 4. And dividing 96 by 4 is very easy. What do we get as the answer? We get 2400 as the answer. Similarly, when we multiply 96 or any other number by 125, then instead of 125, we can take the number as 1000 upon 8. All right. And dividing 96 by 8 is very simple. And what is the answer that we get? We get 12,000 as the answer. Let's see a few more examples and patterns. Just observe this pattern and see how we can solve the problems of multiplication by following this pattern. Now, first one, you can see it is 64 multiplied by 5. That means it is 64 multiplied by 10 upon 2. We can take 5 as 10 upon 2, isn't it? And dividing 64 by 2, what do we get? We get 32. Now, multiplying 32 by 10, very simple. We get it as 320 multiplied by 1, we can write, isn't it? This is to show a certain pattern. Now, coming to the next one, 64 multiplied by 15. Now, you can see what is the difference between 5 and 15? It is taken as 10. All right. And 64 multiplied by 15, in place of 15, we can take it as 30 upon 2, isn't it? And 64 when divided by 2 becomes 32. It becomes 32 multiplied by 30, which can also be written as 320 multiplied by 3, isn't it? Now, see the next one. It is 64 multiplied by 25. Again, what is the difference between 15 and 25? It is 10. All right. And when we multiply 64 by 25, 25 can be taken as 50 upon 2. And 64 divided by 2 becomes 32, then it becomes 32 multiplied by 50, which can also be written as 320 multiplied by 5. All right, now see the last one. It is 64 multiplied by 35. Again, we can see that the difference between 25 and 35 is 10, isn't it? And when we multiply 64 by 35, 35 can be taken as 70 upon 2, isn't it? And 64 when we divide by 2, we get 32, isn't it? 32 multiplied by 70, it can be written as 320 multiplied by 7. Now, in the answers also, you can see a certain pattern, isn't it? They are consecutive odd numbers. The next one, they are all consecutive odd numbers. So think about two more steps which can write which you can write by following the same pattern, isn't it? Now let's start solving the problems of exercise 2.3. So which of the following will not represent 0? The first question. Okay. First one, A is given 1 plus 0. So, when we add 0 to 1, what it becomes? It becomes 1 only, because 0 is the additive identity of 1, isn't it? Whenever we add 0 to any whole number, the answer is the whole number itself. Okay. So, it does not represent 0. We have to find out where we can find 0. Now, 0 multiplied by 0, it becomes 0. Yes, it represents 0. 0 divided by 2, again 0 divided by any number, it becomes 0. Yes, it also represents 0. Now see D, 10 minus 10 upon 2. 10 minus 10 becomes 0, isn't it? And 0 divided by any number is 0. So this one also represents 0. Alright. Now look at the question number 2. If the product of two whole numbers is 0, can we say that one or both of them will be 0? Justify through examples. Okay. So if the product of two numbers is 0, definitely one number will be 0, isn't it? Any number multiplied by 0 becomes 0, isn't it? So what is the example? 0 multiplied by 3 becomes 0. Similarly, 15 if we multiply by 0, it also becomes 0. Any number we multiply, any whole number we multiplied by 0, it becomes 0. Also, if the product of two numbers is 0, the two numbers can also be 0, isn't it? If we multiply 0 by 0, then also we get 0. So in both the cases, if one of the numbers is 0 or both the numbers are 0, we get the product as 0. Okay. Now, let's see the next problem. If the product of two whole numbers is 1, can we say that 1 or both of them will be 1? Justify through examples. Now, if the product of two whole numbers is 1, then definitely both the numbers should be 1 only. They should be equal to 1 only, isn't it? Like 1 multiplied by 1 becomes 1. If we take any other whole number which we multiply with 1 by 1, then it will be the number itself, the whole number itself. Like 1 multiplied by 5 becomes 5. If we take 9, 1 multiplied by 9 becomes 9. It's because 1 is a multiplicative identity of whole numbers, isn't it? Whenever we multiply any whole number by 1, we get the whole number itself. So, for the product to be 1, both the numbers should be 1 only. In that situation only, the product will be 1. If one of the numbers is 1 and another number is some other whole number, then the product will not be equal to 1. Okay. Now, let's look at the next one. This is question number 4, find using distributive property. So, what is the first problem? 728 multiplied by 101. We have to use the distributive property and try to solve it very easily. Okay. So, instead of 101, we can write it as 100 plus 1, isn't it? Now, using distributive property and multiplying 728 by 100 and 728 by 1 and adding them, we get 73,528 as the answer. Alright. We have solved many of such problems while doing the previous exercises also. Now, next one, B is 5,437 multiplied by 1001. So 1001 can be taken as 1001 can be taken as 1000 plus 1, isn't it? Now using distributive property, we will multiply 5437 by 1000 and also by 1 and then add them. Okay, so 5437 multiplied by 1000 plus 5437 multiplied by 1. So, what do we get? Here, what do we get? We get 54,37,000 plus 5,437. Adding them both, we get the answer as 54,42,437. Now, let's move on to the next question, next problem. It is 824 multiplied by 25 is equal to 800, it can be written as 824 multiplied by 20 plus 5, 5 can be written as 20 plus 5, isn't it? Now using distributive property, we can multiply 824 by 20 as well as by 5 and then we add them. So what do we get? When we multiply 824 by 20, we get 16,480. And multiplying 824 by 5, we get 4,120. We add them, and what is the answer that we get? It is 20,600. All right. Now let's move on to the next one. Here we have 4,275 multiplied by 125. Now 125 can be expanded as 100 plus 20 plus 5, isn't it? Now we will multiply 4,275 by each of the numbers inside the bracket. Okay, so it becomes 4,275 multiplied by 100 plus 4,275 multiplied by 20 plus 4,275 multiplied by 5. So what do we get? We get 4,27,500 plus 85,500 plus 21,375. So what is the answer that we get? We get the answer 5,34,375. So by using the distributive property, we have solved the problems very easily, isn't it? Now let's look at the next one. It is 504 multiplied by 35. So here we can expand any of the numbers, 504 or 35. So we have expanded 504 here, which can be written as 500 plus 4, isn't it? Now we will multiply each of the numbers 500 and 4 by 35 and find the sum. Okay, so it is 500 multiplied by 35 plus 4 multiplied by 35. So what do we get? While multiplying 500 by 35, what we can do? We can multiply 35 by 5 and add 2 zeros to it, isn't it? So when we multiply 35 by 5, we get 175 and add 2 zeros to it, isn't it? So it becomes 17,500. Now multiply 35 by 4, it becomes 140. When we add both of these numbers, what do we get? We get 17,640 as the answer. All right. Now let's move on to the next question. This is question number 5. Study the pattern. So here we have a pattern. We have to observe the pattern, and then you have to write the next two steps. Okay, and also you have to check how the pattern works. We have to understand how the pattern works. Okay, the answer that we are getting, are we simply writing it, or is it right? Is it the correct answer? So let's study the pattern first. So let's look at the pattern. It is 1 into 8 plus 1 is equal to 9. The next step is 12 into 8 plus 2 is equal to 98. Third step is 123, that means 123 multiplied by 8 plus 3 is equal to 987. Fourth step, 1234, 1234 multiplied by 8 plus 4 is equal to 9876 or 9876. The next one, the last one, is 12345, that means 12345 into 8 plus 5 is equal to 98765 or 98765. So do you observe any pattern here? Let's look at this. Let's look at the first one. Alright, here the numbers, the first one, the first number, how it increases? It is 1, then it becomes 1, 2 or 12, then it becomes 1, 2, 3 or 123, then it becomes 1234 or 1234. And next step it becomes 12345 or 12345. So we can see that the number is increasing by consecutive numbers, isn't it? First it was 1, then it became 12, then it became 123, then it became 1234, then it became 12345. Okay. And the number to be multiplied with is always 8, isn't it? Always 8. But the number to be added is also increasing along with the number that is being multiplied by 8. It is becoming 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, isn't it? And also you can see a beautiful pattern in the answers also. First it is 9, then it becomes 9, 8, then it becomes 9, 8, 7, then it becomes 9, 8, 7, 6, and then it becomes 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. So what can you observe? The number is in the decreasing order of numbers, isn't it? 9, 98, 987, 9876, 98,765. Okay, the number is increasing, but the digits are in a decreasing order, isn't it? So can we write the next two steps? Definitely we can write. Let's see how we do that. Children, first we can take first one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, that is 12,345. So what we do, we increase the number by this digit, it is 6. We can write it as 1,23,456 multiplied by 8, and here also the number to be added will be 6, isn't it? And what is the answer that we are getting? It will be 987654. That means 987654 according to the pattern, isn't it? And the next step will be 1234567. That means 1234567. We have increased the number by one digit, which digit the digit is the next consecutive number, isn't it? And then multiply it with 8, and the number to be added again is 7, isn't it? And what is the answer that we will get? It is 987654. 43 it should be, alright. It should be 987654, 3, alright. So add 3 here, okay. So this is the answer that we get, alright. So how do we explain it? How we are getting this answer? Is it right? We have to check it. Now how do we do that? Now look at this, children. 12,34,056, when written in expanded form, when we take from the ones place, that means from 6, we can write it as 1111111. Isn't it? That means 1,11,111. 5 can be written as 1111. 5 ones become 5, isn't it? So it is 11,101. Then it becomes 1111. 4 means 1111. That means 1111. And then next one is 111, then next is 11 plus 1. When we add these numbers, we get this one, okay, 1,23,456. This is the expanded form. When we multiply this with 8, we have to multiply this expanded form by 8, alright. So what do we get? We get 8,88,888 plus 88,888 plus 8,888 plus 88 plus 8, isn't it? We are considering the first example, please remember that. All right. So when we add these numbers, what do we get? We get 9,87,648. But still we have to add 6 to it. When we add 6 to it, we get the answer as 9,87,654, that we also got from the by following the pattern, isn't it? So it is 987654. So we can see that the pattern we have followed is right. So the pattern works. Now let's see the next step that we have written, whether it is right or not. Now it is, the next step is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, isn't it? And multiplied by 8 plus 7 is equal to 9,87,654,3. Alright. So what is this number? When we expand this number, 12,34,567, what do we get? We get 111. From 1's place we have to expand, okay? 111111. Isn't it? 711 plus 1,11,111. Then it becomes 11,111. Then it becomes 1,111, 111, then 11 and 1. When we add all these numbers, we get this one. Okay, we get this number. Alright, so we expand the number and multiply it with 8. So what do we get? We get 888888. That means we get 88,88,888 plus 88,88,888. Then we get 88,888 plus 8,888 plus 888 plus 88 plus 8. When we add all these numbers, what do we get? We get 98,76,536, isn't it? But still we have to add 7 to it. When we add 7 to this number, we get this number, that is 98,76,543, which is what we get according to the pattern, isn't it? Which we get according to the pattern, that is 9,87,654,3. So we can say that this pattern also works. Yes, this pattern works. So children, with this question we come to the end of exercise 2.3.